Ladies, how do we know if our hormones are imbalanced? Are premenstrual symptoms such as tender breasts, cramping, fatigue, mood swings, and sugar cravings just part of being a menstruating woman, or are they something else? What should a normal menstrual cycle look like? Hi, I'm Linda Vizzoli, a nutritional therapist and health coach specializing in women's health, and today we'll be finding out if your hormones are imbalanced and what you can do about it. So, what are hormones? Hormones are chemical messengers which regulate different bodily functions such as our metabolism, hunger, our blood sugar, our moods, sleep, growth and development, and even our reproductive health. Now, hormones are made and released by different glands and tissues in the body, and these make up what is called the endocrine system. Now, there are actually around 50 identified hormones in the body, but the main hormones that are involved in the menstrual cycle that are referred to as steroid hormones or sex hormones are estrogen, progesterone, and testosterone. Now, cortisol, our stress hormone, can also be involved, and it can actually impact the production of our sex hormones, causing fluctuations in our hormonal balance. A woman's menstrual cycle is actually an indicator of her overall health. Most of us may think of menstruation as a nuisance or in terms of fertility and pregnancy, but being fertile is not just about making babies. When our menstrual cycle is out of whack, it's a sign that our body does not feel safe enough to reproduce, and that's a message we want to take note of. So what happens during the menstrual cycle? In very broad terms, a woman's cycle is divided into two phases. We have the follicular phase, from the first day of bleeding until ovulation, and then the luteal phase, which is after we ovulate, up until we stop bleeding again. Now, different hormones are involved in these different phases of the cycle, and if there's a disruption during this delicate dance, we will most likely start to see some symptoms of hormonal imbalance. So, let's take a look now at five common signs of hormonal imbalance. Changes in your menstrual cycle. Now, one of the most obvious things you may experience if your hormones are out of balance is a change in your menstrual cycle. Now, you may not know this, but a healthy period should actually be pain-free and just show up on the day it's due with no forewarning, no PMS symptoms. It should have a good flow with no clotting. Now, if things are out of balance, you may notice your periods becoming more irregular, maybe shorter or longer than usual. You may start to skip or even stop getting your period altogether in extreme cases. Your periods may be painful with cramping and pain. You may see clotting or even heavy bleeding. Or you may notice your flow becoming much lighter than usual. Premenstrual symptoms. What about premenstrual symptoms? These are symptoms that you experience a week or two before your period starts. Many women suffer from symptoms such as tender breasts, mood swings, irritability or very low mood, sugar cravings, hot flashes and night sweats, headaches and migraines that are experienced at the same time every month, and changes in our bowel movements before our periods. Now, if you're experiencing these symptoms at certain times in your cycle, it's most likely caused by a hormonal imbalance. Fertility issues. If you're struggling to get pregnant or stay pregnant, chances are that hormones are at play here. We need the right quantity of estrogen to produce a healthy egg and to ovulate in our follicular phase, and we need enough progesterone, our progestation hormone, to maintain a healthy pregnancy. So if you've been on a fertility journey for a while with no success, or have suffered with chemical pregnancies or miscarriages, it's vital to work with an experienced practitioner to address any potential hormonal imbalances and optimize your fertility and chances of getting pregnant. Low sex drive. Whilst it's normal for our libido to be slightly higher before ovulation and wane a little in the second half of your cycle, if your libido is consistently low or absent, then it's a telltale sign that your hormones need some love. Think about it. If your body does not feel safe enough to reproduce, it will downregulate your reproductive health, and libido is one of the functions which will be affected, as there's no point feeling frisky if your body feels that it's a dangerous time to have a baby. Just as an aside, having an insatiable sex drive could also be a sign of hormonal imbalance. Certain health conditions. Now, certain health conditions such as PCOS, endometriosis or adenomyosis, and even uterine polyps, fibroids, or cysts are associated with an imbalance in our sex hormones. If you've been diagnosed with any of these conditions, then addressing the root cause of these imbalances is key in ensuring that we can bring the body back to health. Now, while many of these symptoms are common, they should by no means be considered normal. They're usually our body sending us a message that something is out of balance and needs addressing. The problem is that we just accept them as part of being a woman. Well, I'm here to tell you that you don't have to put up with these issues. So, what can we do if we're experiencing some of the symptoms of hormonal imbalance? These are my top five tips. Number five, reduce exposure to endocrine disruptors. What are endocrine disruptors? They're chemicals that can interfere with our hormonal production. Some of them can even act as hormones in the body, creating an endocrine imbalance. Now, where can we find these chemicals? They can be found in plastics such as cling film, plastic food wrapping, and even Tupperware containers and bottles. They can be found in chemicals in conventional products, like in our personal products or home cleaning products, and even in factory farmed animals or pesticide laden produce. So evaluate the chemicals in your environment and consider switching to a more natural and organic products. Number four, love your liver. Now, our liver is one of the most hardworking organs in our body. And when it comes to hormonal function, optimizing liver function is key. This is where our excess estrogen gets detoxified before being excreted through the bowels. So, love your liver by ensuring that you're eating enough high quality and organic protein and carbohydrates, good quality fats, and magnesium-rich foods. But don't forget to also avoid burdening our liver with regular alcohol consumption or chemicals found in household and personal products. Because if the liver is busy detoxifying alcohol or chemicals, it won't have time to do many of its other functions, including hormonal detoxification. Number three, aim for daily bowel movements. As we've just seen, our liver is responsible for detoxifying and inactivating any excess hormones, especially estrogen, in our bodies. But once it has inactivated them, it puts them in a nice little package with a bow on it and sends them over to the colon to be excreted forever. If, however, we're not having a daily bowel movement, this package just sits in our colon where an enzyme essentially takes the bow off the package and sends that estrogen back into circulation. Now, this can lead to higher levels of estrogen in the system. So irregular bowel movements or constipation can not only make us feel sluggish and congested, but can also manifest in hormonal issues. So if we want to get that estrogen out, we need to poop every day. Evaluate your diet and ensure you're drinking enough fluids daily and consuming fiber-rich foods such as fruits and vegetables, beans and legumes, and whole grains. Number two, reduce stress. Our stress hormones, cortisol and adrenaline, have an impact on the production of our sex hormones. So if you've been experiencing hormonal symptoms, you should definitely address your source of stress. Now, this can be anything from personal stress or emotional stress, work stress, over-exercising, under-eating or erratic eating, disrupted sleep, exposure to toxins in our food and our environment, and even lots of blue light exposure. Addressing stress is key in hormonal health. Number one, nourish yourself. We need plenty of nutrients for our body to function optimally. And if we're undernourished, our body will prioritize our systems of survival before reproduction, which is not essential for survival. So stop dieting. Ensure that you're eating enough nutritious food daily, especially if you're very active, and that you're including antioxidant and mineral-rich fruits and vegetables, as well as including healthy fats. Now, we need fats to make our sex hormones, so if you're on a low-fat diet, you may actually be lacking a key macronutrient for hormonal production. When thinking about nutrition, it's also essential to balance our blood sugar, because blood sugar balance and hormone balance go hand in hand. If we're on a blood sugar roller coaster every day, we'll be constantly activating our stress mechanisms, which will have a negative impact on our progesterone and estrogen balance. We can balance our blood sugar by ensuring that we are not skipping meals or eating erratically, and that we're combining carbs and protein and a little fat with every meal. If you're seriously struggling with hormonal imbalances, you may want to get tested to find out exactly what is the cause of your symptoms. Functional tests such as the Dutch test, which stands for dried urine test for comprehensive hormones, or salivary hormone panels, or panels that can map your cycle, can assess exactly what is going on with your sex hormones. You can work with a naturopathic practitioner to explore these options further. Let us know if you have any questions or feedback in the comments below. We'll be delving into the subject of hormones in more detail in other episodes, so don't forget to subscribe to our channel to stay up to date with our future releases.